I think the sound should be working. Everything else should be okay. Let's see what we can do here. Alrighty. Looks like everything's working. Let me try the chat thing. Yeah, the chat window looks a little weird. Maybe I'll do like a boxed version of that or something. Yeah. Oh, that's better. Nice. Cool. All right, nice ambient music to get this started. All right, there is nobody in here yet, but I'm gonna get going here. Start on some things. I think I need like a marker or something. I'm gonna grab a marker. I will be right back. Things here. Just need to make a mark on that. Lars, how are you, sir? What am I breaking? Dude, check this out. This is my little tape deck. My little boom box. I'm gonna circuit bend this stupid thing. You know? Cause I've never circuit bent an actual cassette player before, but I got some ideas on how to make this do some funky stuff. So, but first thing we gotta do is we gotta put quarter inch output on, if you can see that, quarter inch output on the actual thing itself, because you know the eighth inch out that's on here is, that's for suckers. So I'm gonna take care of that first. Need to figure out how to, I don't know what the hell this is. There's just a random wire hanging in here. I swear I didn't put that in there. So, anyway, I gotta get this quarter inch out on here. I could probably tap the headphone jack that's on here. There is a headphone jack on the side. Can't really see it or not. Yeah, I guess you can't see it. That's that eighth inch, 3.5 millimeter crap. But those are not reliable, so. Let me test this and see where the connectors are in the back, and we're just gonna solder to it. It's totally gonna work. Alright, let's do this. Let's do 120 volts. Turn this thing on. Should get something from this. Let's see. Nothing? It's making weird noise for sure. This is probably gonna be a super annoying stream with all sorts of weird crap happening here. Alright, am I grabbing that one? Or am I grabbing this one? Does this really have stereo output on it? I didn't think it did. Well, we're not doing stereo out. This is going mono. Okay, I think I figured it out. So, what we're gonna do first is I need to drill a hole in the plastic to actually, you know, get that rolling. Alright, let's find drill bits and stuff. Let's see, what do we need here? Not that guy. 3/8, that's gonna be huge. No, that'll fit. Alright, 3/8 it is. Watch me rip the plastic of this stupid thing open. So what I can do is once I get this headphone or the actual quarter inch jack on here, I will be able to plug this direct into the to the stream so that we can hear really what's going on with it. So it should be kind of fun. I'm trying not to break the wires here. Ooh. Get this out of the way. Let's just do that, I guess, for now. I think I'm just gonna put it right here. This is fun shit. You gotta go slow with this plastic, though. By that I mean go slow, like don't push hard. Gotta be patient. Otherwise it cracks. I could crack it, but we'll see what happens. Hoping for a nice clean hole though. What the hell is going on here? Alright, so through, but it's not out of the woods yet. Kind of bit a little bit. Jackpot Pinball. Oh, dude. Bill, how are you, sir? I was like, Jackpot Pinball, I know that. Yeah, so Bill, I'm doing something a little crazy. So, there's something called circuit bending, which is basically where you take, There we go. Go in reverse when you're getting through the last bit of thin plastic, and you should be able to pop through without killing anything. So circuit bending. I'm going to probably be explaining this a whole bunch tonight. That is great that you are doing awesome. I heard JJP moved local, which is really cool, man. They moved back to Chicago here. Or not back, but I mean everything to Chicago. So that's awesome, actually. So circuit bending. Basically what you do is you take... what I did was I took children's toys that you would get from, you know, like the thrift store or something. And you basically just... You kind of hotwire them and you rewire them so that they start making just really crazy sounds. And what you can do is you can sample those sounds. And then we can use those in you know, my music production and stuff like that. So it's actually super cool. So I'm going to show you tonight about what I do when I go about doing this. So, all right. So first step. Quarter inch output needs to happen on here because it's a musical instrument now. No comment is perfect, man. It's all good. Alright, so just gonna move this stuff out of the way. The hole I drilled was good. Okay, get the washer on here. So I'm gonna mount it first before I solder it. Just, you know, it just makes it easier so I'm not fumbling with wires and stuff. Hopefully I don't have to get up too much and like go to the garage and get tools and stuff tonight doing this. That's always kind of annoying. You know, I'm gonna turn this my direction for a moment just so I can get the pliers on here. Not rotate this thing. Alright. So, first things first, let's get some wire. And then I'm going to jump. What I'm going to do is I'm going to jump these wires over to the little eighth inch output, and that should give us a good place to grab the audio from. I don't want to grab it from the speaker unless I have to. Usually in the kids' toys, when you're doing this to kids' toys and stuff, you grab it from the speaker, just because that's the best or the easiest way to get it. But sometimes that level is a little bit hot for some audio equipment. So I'm going to try not to blow up my workstation here. You know, normal stuff. Okay. By the way, these vice grip wire strippers, man. These rock. All right. So I don't know. I mean, Lars, are you familiar with circuit bending at all? I don't know if you've ever seen anything like this or not. Let's see. All right. So I'm going to tin these guys. Let's get some solder. You guys can kind of see what I'm doing. A little bit anyway. I'm gonna try and keep this as clean as I can on the inside, even though these always end up looking shitty on the inside. But yeah, so this is like the stage one of circuit bending, is just getting the toy or whatever you're circuit bending to have an audio output that you can just plug in with, you know, a 1/4-inch cable. Oh yeah, Lars, I still have that NES, man, like from 10 years ago or more. Oh shit, I think I built that in 2004 is when I built that NES. That's when you and I were hanging out on the scene back in the day. Cool. So hey, I'm gonna tin this too, get this thing all fired up. Okay. I should have grabbed some like zip ties or something too. But you know what? I don't care. This thing's a piece of junk. Alright, so first things first, let's get this side on. Let's get that all done there. Okay. There we go. And we'll get this side on here. I mean, basically, you guys are just, like, watching me work, so hopefully you're okay with that. All right, so that is the ground is this guy, so I'm going to move this one around here. I know where the ground is on this, so I'm going to put a little solder blob on there. I think I have the wrong soldering iron tip, but you know what? Who cares? No one's judging me. You guys can barely see what I'm doing, probably, anyway. Okay. I'm going to put a solder blob here. Oh, they use lead-free solder. Gross. Seems like made in China. Why did they use lead-free solder? Okay, I think I'm going to do that. Get that on there. Okay. Just another word of advice too. You should never blow on the solder joints when you're doing them, when you're trying to get them to cool. I have this nasty habit of doing that. It's just not good for them. Because they can cold solder crack later on. Okay. Now, that should be all working there. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna plug this in, and then I'm gonna take my headphones and pop them on there real quick. Give me one second. So I should be able to just plug my normal 1/4-inch headphones in, and I should be getting a signal from it. So let me just test it before I stick it into my equipment. I'd rather blow up a pair of headphones than my workstation. All right, I got nothing. Wait, it's mono. That is why. It's working though. I think it sounds pretty good. Jeez, that's loud. That's loud and really, really shitty sounding. Perfect. So this is working, and it's going to be an unbalanced output. Okay, nice. So that's done. That means we can move on to something more fun. Yeah, touch it with your tongue. You know what, Wolfman, you know, all joking aside, like if you're just looking, like, and you don't have your multimeter around with your circuit bending stuff, you can just like touch two wires to your tongue and see what it is. This is all low voltage. So I just wanted to just emphasize this again. Actually, I don't think I said this yet, but anything that you circuit bend, if you're gonna do any of this stuff, you cannot have it plugged into the mains. Like you have to have it running on battery power because you will electrocute yourself, you will fry circuit boards and all sorts of crap just way too easy. There's a very, very high risk that I'm going to actually destroy this tonight in like to the point where it's just garbage. So that'll probably be fun. We'll see though. The first thing I want to do though is now that I've got my output, if you guys can see that, look at that. Straight up output. That's awesome. I checked for clearances too. It should be good. I should be able to bolt this back together, no problem. The first thing I want to do is a really good circuit bending technique that you can pretty much do on almost any anything, like any kid's toy, anything like this, is it's called a power starve. So basically what you do is you try to find a variable resistor or a potentiometer, and you see this coming in here. So this side of the back side here where the batteries are, it's plugged in here with the positive and negative. I actually marked that with a marker already, like just take a Sharpie and I drew on there where this red and black wire are coming in. Now the power starve, all I do is I take off the positive and I run this positive line through a potentiometer, something like a 10K potentiometer. And what I can do is I can then turn it full on, which will give it full power, but then I can also back it down. So I start backing down that potentiometer and it will start bringing the voltage level of the entire system down. And what that does is that really screws with operational amplifiers and you know, just regular audio amplifiers and all sorts of other circuitry. I don't know if you ever heard a, if any of you guys have kids, you probably know this, but like when the kids' toys' batteries start dying and like in the middle of the night you hear this like satanic voice coming from one of their toys, it's because it's a power starve, it's power starving the entire thing and it's causing it to freak out. So it usually ends up with a lot of distortion and other just wacky things. And you can combine power starves with other little circuit bend things and it starts doing really strange things. But you know, basically I'm just trying to release different sounds out of this thing than it could normally do. So we're going with some of the safe bends first. We're gonna get those going. I'm gonna show you what they sound like and do, and then we're gonna go into more of the experimental stuff where I start poking around on the circuit board itself and you know, really potentially could just explode this thing. So it should be pretty fun. I was going to do this anyway, so I figured I would just turn the stream on, so it's not going to be super interesting. I've got just like random ambient music in the background, if you guys can hear that. So there's not dead silence when I'm, you know, not doing something, or I'm not talking, I mean. Okay, so I think what I'm going to do, though, is since this thing's going to be totally circuit bent, I'm going to need some places for switches. I might pull this speaker out and use the, like, just pull the speaker out. This is actually wired in series with the other speaker, so they're 4-ohm speakers wired in series, which brings it to 8 ohms. I am going to risk burning out the amplifier and I'm just gonna take this speaker out and because there's not a lot of space in here because there's a transformer. I'm trying to visualize like how this goes back together and I'll take the speaker out and then I'll be able to use this panel right here. This is metal to put switches and buttons on and stuff. So, recorded at 240. Yeah, for sure. That sounds like an awesome, awesome idea. But yeah, let's take the speaker out and see what's going on here. See what we got. These are like the shittiest little China speakers ever. I mean, not that I was expecting anything different, but you know. But we'll see if this is even a viable option. Before I totally bypass the speaker, I will... I'm going to just double check that I can even screw things into this front panel. What the hell is going on here? How the hell did they get this in here? God damn, I'm gonna break it out of here. Yeah, there you go. Ugh. You hear that? That's, oh, they got some kind of shitty glue in here. Oh, wow, it's just a little paper cone. That is awful. That's an awful, awful speaker. Okay. Actually, that's plastic? What is that? I don't know what that is, but I think this is gonna be a good... This will be a good place to put some switches and stuff. We don't need the other speaker. We've got the actual quarter inch out that we'll be using. Most circuit bent things, you don't really use the speaker anymore because it's like, yeah, it's kind of useless. So I am going to cut these off. Do I have an actual pair of cutters? No? Okay. All right then. And I'm gonna take these two, since this is wired in series, I have to actually connect these two wires together. So I'm gonna do it the right way. I'll put a little heat shrink tubing on it even just to be safe. I got some heat shrink. All right. Just a little piece of this. Look at that, I'm doing stuff the right way. You know what? If I wasn't on stream, I bet you I wouldn't do this the right way. I'd probably just twist it together and then hope for the best. Hey, that didn't strip out. Hold on. These wires are so thin for these speakers. It's ridiculous. They're like barely any copper. Holy shit. They're like, what's the... They talk to their engineers or something. They're like, what's the minimum gauge wire we can use for this? For actual, like, audio level speaker shit. I'm afraid the solder is going to... Or the soldering iron is going to burn through it. So damn thin. Okay. Do that. Lighter here. Heat shrink. Fun stuff. If you guys have any questions about circuit bending too, you can give me, just throw it in the chat. I'll answer when I can. Circuit bending is it's a weird thing. I've been doing it for quite a while, but all right. So where do we want to put the potentiometer for the power starve? I wonder if we should put it over on this side here so that we know it's like a power starve, or maybe we should just put it in the front. Yeah, I'm gonna put it in the front. On that front panel. Well, let's try it first. Let me find a potentiometer, 10K. I just got like a random box of parts here that I use for circuit bending. What's this one? Of course it doesn't say, so I'll have to test it. Here's a 10K. Wonder how... Does this fit on here? Oh, those knobs don't fit on these things. I got some other knobs in here, I'll try. Yeah, I don't like that. Just wanna be sure that the potentiometer I'm selecting actually can... Like, is actually compatible with a knob that I can use here. Yeah, I'll use one of these. Okay. All right. 10K. So this one, I am going to test it before I actually mount it. Oh, it's one of these fucking shitty ones. Some of these potentiometers have little, like, I don't know if you guys can see that or not, but it's like a, it's not gonna focus. But see that little thing right there? It's to keep it from rotating. I should just break them off. For projects like this, they're not necessary. All right, so what we need is a piece of wire. I need to desolder the positive from here. Okay. And grab a piece of jumper. Okay. Where did I decide I was gonna put this? On the front panel? Alright. Front panel will be, I'll need an extension on this guy then. So I'll need an extension. Chaka, thank you for the follow. I appreciate that. I don't know if the sounds are coming through or not, but... This wire is overkill, man. This is like 22 gauge wire. It's just crazy overkill for what I'm using it for. All right, you need to go from here to there and need to get out of the way. I need two of these. Using a pair of needle nose pliers as wire cutters just is not fun. It actually just sucks. I can't wait to see what ends up power starve this. And so keep in mind too, I've never circuit bent a thing like this. I always circuit bend kids' toys. So I don't even know if this is gonna work. Who knows? But the power starve should do some weird things. It'll definitely slow down the tape when you're playing a tape. But not sure what else it'll do. Okay. That one. And all I've got is black wire, so yeah. Cheesy porn music in the background. I don't even know what I'm listening to. It's just like an ambient station. I'm trying to listen to music that's not like hyper recognizable by like YouTube algorithms and stuff. Because I don't want this being muted for later on, you know what I mean? I want people to be able to watch this later. And in fact, I might like just turn it down even more, you know, so then I don't run into issues. It sucks how all that stuff works. Oh my God, the wire is so damn thin. It's like, come on. Holy shit. How is this even like legit, man? I guess it's really not, it's just China crap. All right, well, hope this holds. I'll put heat shrink on it again, so it's, this is like sleeping music. But hopefully we won't run into issues with it. Okay. Let's not screw up anything here. Heat shrink is also really good for like holding the wires in place too. It doesn't, you know, it's not just to insulate. Okay, so there's one side. This side needs a bit of tinning. I should probably tin the other thing too. Let's get this. You know, some of my friends write really good ambient music. I should have just, like, played some of their stuff. Sorry, you can't see what I'm doing, but I'm just tinning the ends of these wires here so I can easily do this. Okay, so here is our positive. Okay, nice solid connection there. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to power starve. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna connect to the, if you can see this or not, which camera is clear, who knows, maybe that one. Okay, so I'm going to want to turn down the power, so I wanna turn the knob that way. So I'm gonna connect it to both of these two, and that will kind of starve it in this direction. So, move this up, the speaker's junk. Go ahead and tin this as well. I'm just going to put these right on the terminals. If this doesn't work, I will I'll put it in the little there's little holes for this as well. You guys still digging the cheesy porn music in the background? I hope this thing doesn't have like a battery protection or something on it, because this won't work then. Like when the battery gets low, it just like shuts off. Okay. Now everything is connected. I'm gonna do this. I am going to plug into a 1/4-inch cable. I'm actually gonna plug this direct into the audio card so you guys can hear it. So let's try that. Okay, so that's that. That's that. Now I think I have to set up my Streamlabs really quick. Hold on. To get the audio capture. I'm going to pause this music because it's, you know, peaceful and stuff. Let's see. Hold on. The music might come through. Let's see. Is that not working? Hold on. Properties. Oh, there's nothing. Oh, okay. I gotcha. There's nothing coming through yet. It's going to just grab the audio from this thing. So, let's kick it on. All right. So you guys should hear some stuff out of the left channel. Hopefully that's not like crazy, crazy loud. Holy shit. What is this music? Okay, so there's...
You're gonna die and you're not in control of wind.
Okay, so you guys can hopefully still hear me too. Here we go. Here we're gonna power starve it and see what happens.
That's what frightens people.
Okay, so this just gets... Okay, so it just turns the volume down on this thing. But you can see this thing does freak out. This thing does freak out a bunch. Hold on. Let me get a clearer station. Okay, so it does screw with... It is distorting the preamps. So that makes a nice distortion, if you can hear that. I'm going to mute myself for a second. Okay, enough of that. All right, so that did work. The power starve does actually starve it. So what I'm going to do is I need to drill a hole in the front to mount. I'm going to, for now, unplug that so you guys don't hear anything. Let's see, can you get the whole 60 hertz, like, ground thing? Nice. So that totally worked. Now I'm happy with that. So what we're going to do is let's mount it. So I'm just going to drill a hole through the grate on this. I got to figure out what drill bit it is. Hold on. Probably this one. Yep. Yeah, this will work. So could you guys hear that at all? Like, I hope you could. I didn't get any confirmation. Okay, cool. Information tray, how are you? All right, so I'm gonna put this like front and center. The whole thing off. Hold on. I'll fix this. I'll drill it and then I'll stick it back on. This is actually metal. Like, this is straight up metal. I have a feeling this is gonna, like, cut me if I don't do this right. I hope I can get that back on okay. Oh, I know. I see. It's just bent down there. Perfect. This will be fine. All right, let me go get something to grab this with. Hold on. I don't want to slice my hand, so I'm gonna, you know, do that. Okay. Now, I can just hold this over the garbage can and over here. Here we go. I kind of made a mess of it. Luckily, it's metal. We can bend it all back. Cool. And I did not cut myself, which is nice. Okay, so our first thing is down here. Let me get, hook this up first, and then we'll stick it back on there. I think I like drilling through the plastic better, honestly. Hope this doesn't ground out on here. Eh, whatever. Circuit bent, man. Does all sorts of weird crap. We'll see what happens. Touching? What the hell? I'm gonna have to put some electrical tape on the back side of this because it's looking like it's touching. And it's a metal grate, so, you know. Easy fix. I want to try that power starve with an actual tape, which is exactly what I'm going to do as soon as I get this mounted. We're going to power this thing up and put a tape in it and see what it sounds like. Because it should slow it down like crazy and start distorting it. Gotta love how there's no protection on the amplifiers, so low voltage protection. Okay, let's put this back in. Slide that guy in there. Get back in there, you. Here we go. I'll be more careful with it that time. I'll drill it from the opposite side next time. Okay, so now we've got our power starve right in the front. And we can go get a tape. Well, actually, you know what? Let's put a knob on it. Make it look nice. Using a screw type knob here. Is this all the way up? Yep, it's all the way up. It's going to give us some good resolution there. Okay. Nice. So first mod is in. Cool. Nice. All right. Let's get a tape here. What tape should we listen to? Alright, so I made a mixtape a while ago called Skull Smashing Techno. Here, here's proof. Skull Smashing Techno. We're gonna use that because this will probably not get me blocked by the YouTubes. Alright, tape. We need to. Alright. We turn off all the rest of this. I'll mute myself, although it's probably sounding like crap right now. Okay, so that power starve does not work as well with a tape running because the tape is drawing so much power for that motor, but it does run really well on the radio. So, oh, geez, can I find like a radio station? Anything? Hold on, let me get the antenna going. Oh, is the antenna not even hooked up? Ooh, AM radio, you guys. AM.
We have anything to show for now going into year four of a new tactics when it comes to North Korea?
We've made absolutely no progress on denuclearization or getting any kind of change in North Korean behavior. Recently, North Korea...
That's kind of cool. It just sounds like it's kind of out of tune, though. Out of tune. That's a cool sound. That's awesome. That's the amp shutting on, or like something's triggering it on and off. I wonder if I can take... I'm gonna put a resistor across this to just give it a little bit more power. Cause at 10K, it's coming off. Is that overheating that thing? Nah. I wanna give this just a little more juice. So. I wonder if I can piggyback. Hold on a second. I gotta think for a minute. I could probably piggyback two potentiometers. 10K might be the lowest I got. Hold on. Let me think. That's fine. It's just touchy. We'll just leave it at that. Okay. I do want to do one where we power starve the motor itself. We could power starve the motor a bit, but we're technically doing that with the main power starve, so I don't know if that's going to be a good mod. I wonder if we should just dig into this thing and start poking around and seeing what we can do. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make myself a little probe wire, and we're gonna see what's going on here. There's a lot of connection points on the back here that we can screw with. So I'm gonna turn on AM radio again, I think. Turn the power all the way up. Sorry about that, guys. All right. Let me kill the... There we go. Okay, so you are now hearing the AM radio when we power starve this guy. So that's totally power starved. Those are some cool noises. Okay.
Come to download our guide. You can protect your retirement with precious metals. That's noblegoldinvestments.com.
Yeah, Noble Gold Investments. Here, I'm just going to play a tape. And I'm going to poke around on the audio amp side and see what I can get. Sorry, that's only coming out of the left channel. It's unbalanced into my thing here, so. So this, you guys, this is where I could actually just fry this thing and make it not function anymore. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hedge my bets slightly. I don't want to blow it up quite yet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a resistor. I have no idea what value this is. What's up, Kevin? I'm going to take this resistor and just twist it around this little probe. So I've made this little probe, right, with just a piece of wire and a resistor. And we're going to start looking around for stuff. I know I can take... There's an amp chip, like, right here. I can get hold of this IC and do some weird stuff to it. Okay, the IC is not responding to that. I'm gonna take the audio and I'm gonna backfeed it back into some these other places. This is circuit bending and just exploring around a little bit. This resistor might be super high value. Hold on. You know what? Fuck it. Let's not use a resistor. Aw, Kev, that's gross, man. That sucks. That's really bad. That's pretty concerning, man. You guys can enjoy my crazy hard techno track in the left channel. Left channel only, you know? Yeah, man, just watch yourself, Kev. You should stay away from everybody if you can. There's something there. That's short. That was dead short. Oh shit, I thought I killed it. Is that like power or what is that? Hold on. Ooh, that's 5 volts straight up. I shouldn't be poking around with that. Negative 5, so... Okay, so there's some power lines. Let's stay away from that. What's this one? That's a power line. Could try and... I just need some signal. So I'm going to try and grab... Let's see here. This could be a signal off of here. I hope that's the tape ending and not me blowing this shit up. Sorry about that, guys. Hopefully that's not too loud. Oof. Alright. Where's that resistor? Alright, let's try that again. Ooh, I'm like grounded. It's definitely doing some weird crap. So that's a good sign. It hasn't exploded. So it just makes a bunch of clicky sounds so far. I'll find something. Man, this song's a little, I don't know if you can hear this. It's a creepy song. It's a creepy song. Okay. I want to get... So the amp section is here, I believe. That's an interesting thing right there, just me touching it. Oh, this is a tape deck, Kev. Wow, that thing's really sensitive. It's just shutting down. Tape is the best tape. And this is playing a tape. I don't know if you guys can see that. Actually, it's spinning and shit in there. You can hear it for sure, right? It's just left channel only. Oof. That didn't sound good. That's awful. There is a big capacitor on here, but it says I gotta look at the rating on it so I don't freaking electrocute myself on it. Hold on. It's probably low voltage. There's a bunch of capacitors on here, actually. This whole thing's running at 6 volts, but I don't know if it has any step-up voltage in it or anything. It would be cool to be able to slow down the tape. Did I just kill it? Oh, it's the end of the tape. End of the tape. Oh, what's step-up voltage? All right, so there are a bunch of circuits that can actually do something called a step-up voltage, which can get you from... This thing's running at 6 volts. It can use 6 volts at, you know, we'll say like 1 amp or something like that to get to like a ridiculous amount of voltage at a lot lower amperage. So that's a step-up circuit. I really doubt this thing has any step-up capability in it. But, you know, whatever. It makes for good. Nothing in here will kill me, so. It'll make for a good stream. But anyway, here's the tape deck. This is what it looks like. I've already got a power drain, or a power starve on it. So listen to this. I think I am gonna put a power starve on the actual motor itself. Turn that off. I'm gonna pull this and put a power starve on it because just I'm feeling like it. Okay. Let's do this. I am going to drill this first. It's never clean through this metal. I wonder if I should replace it with like a piece of plastic or something. No idea. Okay, so now that I've got that, I should try to straighten it out a little bit. So it's not so cruddy looking. All right, yeah, good enough. Cool. Alrighty, so let's power starve the motor by taking the positive lead off and getting an extension cable for it. Again, I don't know if I'm going to find anything awesome on this, like any awesome bends on this thing. I hope I do, but... No guarantee, as it's not a kid's toy. Get this guy off of here. Get a little piece of heat shrink tubing. Ultimately, I'm just really making a mess. Oh, I had some heat shrink tubing here. Just gonna extend this down. Cut this extremely, extremely thin wire. Oh my god. It's crazy how thin it is. Absolutely crazy. I need to put some more ambient music on here for you guys. Just start that back up. I was running running ambient music in the background. Ah, here we go. So it doesn't sound so quiet when I'm not talking. Oh, I got some nice waves going on. Sounds of the waves. Perfect for circuit bending. Where's my lighter? Okay, so there's one side of it. I need to get some more wire. Oh god, not ambient. I don't know what else to listen to that's not going to get me, you know, kicked off and by the, or muted. I want this to be available later, so, you know. Breakcore. Could play some breakcore, but a lot of it, though, you'd be surprised. It'll play some, like, Aphex Twin or something, and then I'll get screwed. You know what, though? This is really, this is the best kind of music for this, Dan, because it's like a spa waiting room. Oh, I cannot wait to power drain this thing. This is going to be really funny. So, this is going to be cool, because I mean, everyone knows what a slowed down tape sounds like, but it's just kind of neat to be able to just do it on the fly. Okay, get this on here. So that, there we go. Now we got the two leads here. And I'm going to put them on this guy. We're going to go on the right and left. Okay. Should get some solder on those. So I'm just tinning everything so it's easier to work with later. Oh, so peaceful. Give it the bends. Like a sick sailor. No, those are divers. Divers get the bends. Don't they? Isn't that a diver thing? Oh, god damn it. Okay. Got a good solid connection there. So before I mount this or anything, I'm gonna go ahead and try it. So let's pause the music. Let's play this. All right, you guys should be able to hear that. Oh, it pretty much just dies automatically. God, that's not a fun one. Try something. Okay. Okay, that's too much resistor. What the hell? I got a bad connection. All right, this one's not cool. I don't like this one. There's something wrong with this piece of shit. What the hell is going on with this potentiometer? Yeah, resistance is futile. Okay, I'm going to put a different resistor value on there. I'm just going to try a couple ones and see what happens. Hey. Same deal with that one.
That one does.
What?
It sounds like you've taken up like building model trains, and it's like choo 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 choo. It sounds
weird.
Like upstairs. It sounds like the motor of like a model train.
This is sort of like model trains.
Totally. Just come check on the progress.
Yeah, it's working a little bit, but nothing too interesting yet.
All right, well.
Nothing too interesting yet. We'll see. We'll see what happens. I'm not expecting too much. This thing's it's a piece of junk. This one works better. And it stops. Okay. All right, I'm gonna solder this in here. Well, I don't know. Maybe I should find a better value. I'm gonna look up this resistor value really quick and see what it is. It's a green, blue, brown, gold. Gotta look that up though. Let's see, we need resistor value, resistor calculator, sure. Oh yeah, Dan, I know you do. Okay, 4-band, it is, let me just double check again, green, blue, maybe brown, gold. Green, blue, brown, gold. That is a 560 ohm resistor. Crystal is so gold. 560. So we probably need, let me think about this for a second, to get some better resolution. I should go up. I'm going to try something. Where's my resistor? All right, so every single self-respecting nerd has... crystal is so cold. Gotcha. Every self-respecting electronics nerd has a binder full of resistors, because that's normal. 560. Let's go to... should I try? How about 360? I'm gonna try 360. Cause why not? 360. Oops, don't put that there. Put this back, right? Put it back where it belongs. Okay. Let's see if this has enough to... Binder full of women, oh my god. This is pretty good. John, I am circuit bending a tape deck. I don't think it's gonna work. I think I got a bad potentiometer here. I was gonna piggyback this with another resistor to see if I could get it to, I don't have anything, like, smaller than a 10K potentiometer, I don't think. Let me check my, little parts bin here. Yeah, it doesn't look like I got anything good for that. What if... Hold on a second. I'm gonna put a capacitor on there. It should allow me I don't think that's gonna work. Yeah, potentiometer is like busted. Alright, the motor thing not working too well. I'm gonna actually take this one out. I'm gonna take this one out and we will save this one for a different motor. Oh, that potentiometer wasn't working right. I gotta see what the hell's going on with that. Jimmy, what's up, man? Yeah, no, I'm not building a pin. I'm building a circuit bent tape player, which I don't think is actually going to do anything, which isn't really going to work, but because it doesn't have a synthesizer in it. Usually you have to have like some sort of synthesizer in whatever you're bending to make it work. All right. So I took that out. We're not going to do that one, but... I still like the power drain. The power drain does some cool stuff. Alright. Well, I'm going to poke around with a resistor, and I'm going to see if I can get something to do anything here. There's gonna be lots of like popping noises and crap too. If I could do the hip hop air horn, oh my god. I was at Houston and I found that damn button, man, during my live set. That was hilarious. Or during my DJ set, I mean. That resets something. That's crazy. There's an IC right here that's pissed. Just like resets it. That's crazy. Yeah, this thing is mad. Pew pew pew. Yeah, I know, right? Sorry about that, it's just killing it. Some techno. This is the lighting. Thank you. I mean, I guess that's power, so stop fucking with that. Switch. I think the op amp is right here, but I can't find any other like bad data to throw at it. So what if I take the audio out? Feedback. Put it back on radio for a second. See if I get any kind of weird craziness from it. Jeez, AM radio is depressing, guys. I'm trying to get this thing to feedback, but it's just not doing it at all. Dude, this, there's nothing interesting on this board. I think I found something interesting. From CBS, a Dunstan, Illinois judge overturned Governor Pritzker's stay-at-home order extension. This brings to the federal judge orders. Alright, I think I figured out something. I am going to... I'm going to get a pretty big... Hopefully I can find like a 500 AM.
Okay.
I found a 500 ohm. That is like tough.
Georgians were allowed to venture back to movie theaters and restaurants today. Correspondent Mark Strassman in Atlanta. Joining up is an American contagion. A waitress wearing a mask and gloves tried to serve reassurance. Central service returned today to Atlanta's four Bad Daddy burger bars. There's hand sanitizers that they will be used. We have disposable menus. Any Georgia restaurant could reopen. From a breakfast chain to a local pizzeria.
Alright, remaking stuff. Play The Exorcist through it. I know, right?
They had everything they needed. The leaders of Texas
are clamoring for the federal government to do more to secure the supply. President's new blueprint for testing killed the coronavirus, describing the administration as the supplier of last resort. Still, the White House now says it will ensure states get what they need. Stephen Portnoy, CBS News, Washington.
More delays and frustration for small business owners hoping for a piece of the new relief bill. CBS.
Sorry guys, I'm just going to have to solder this on here just for testing. Okay. Alright, let's see what we can do here. Just burn myself on this thing. That's okay. I'm just going to solder this in just temporarily.
A drugstore chain is working on souped up deliveries to get medications and essentials to people more quickly during the pandemic. CBS says it's working with UPS to launch its first
drone delivery next Monday to the Villages retirement community northwest of Orlando. The Dow closed up 358 points. This is CBS News. You can listen to CBS News Radio 24 hours a day, 7 days a week on radio.com or the radio.com app. Download it today.
The radio.com app.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we have great prices every day. So during our big spring sale, you know the savings will be huge. Right now, save big on lawn and garden supplies. Like $7 on 36-pound bags of estate weed and plus fertilizer.
Just get this out here, and then I can take this guy and temporarily put it on here.
BioAdvanced tree and shrub protected seed concentrate is just $14.99 a quart after the $5 mail-in rebate. And your 25... Sorry, no rain check.
It crosses a threshold. It does something really weird. And it doesn't come back, which is very odd. I think I'm fucking up the tuner. Yeah, this is totally jacking the tuner up.
Protection program. State Council says it has 100.
Everyone being removed.
It's like switching it to like some weird band. Yeah, that's jacking up the tuner, man. It's pretty cool, though. Try FM. Let's get something on FM and then we'll see what's going on. Hopefully, nothing copyright. I think the FM is totally jacked. Weird. Not really doing too much. It's kind of boring. All right. Not that one. Let's see what else we can find. Sorry, you guys are just hearing like static in the background because of that. Of something. That's The Exorcist right there, if I've ever heard it. God, they use lead-free solder in China. Anyone else surprised by that? Okay, that's an interesting bend point. So check this out. Let's see if we can get it to do anything for it. You guys can hear this like raw because it sounds cool as hell. Thank you. Okay, well, I have unlocked hell. You are absolutely correct. Now, this is really interesting because I'm going to put a switch somewhere. Where am I going to put a switch? I could run a switch up here, I suppose, somewhere in here. Hopefully it doesn't hit anything. Let's see. It just goes in there. Nice. Because that's like a freaking... That's a mess when you turn that on. Love it. Take this off of here real quick. So I think that I could take that right to... So that's going to the volume knob. I'm backfeeding audio into the volume knob is what's happening right there, which is just crazy. Let's see here if I can get this to... Oh, does it just not work anymore? Did I absolutely kill it? Could be the end of the tape. Hold on. Oh, the tape came open. Jesus. Check and see what this is set at right now. I'm just checking this potentiometer here. It gets loud. Sorry, guys. Thank you. can I just touch? I gotta get that back somehow. I guess it can't be a switch, it's gotta be that potentiometer. It's gotta be the potentiometer. So, I'm gonna go ahead and, yeah, make a thing for this. Make a little harness. That'll reach. Then I just need to make an extension on this guy. All right. So this, we did find something weird in here, but it's not like amazing or anything. Definitely not amazing, but it's definitely something cool that we can make happen. So, all right. Tin these guys. Get my mouse out of here. See how this gets so messy so quickly. It's crazy when you're doing circuit bending stuff. Here's another one. Here we are. Everything gets messy. But yeah, so I'm gonna put this last bend in really quick, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna seal it up. It's not going to fit where I want it. Let me try one of the smaller ones. Hold on. Try 10K on here and see what happens. Okay, let's give this a shot. Ah, it's hot. Oh yeah, let's hook up the other side of this. It would also help get more solder on there. Okay, let's see if we can get this to do some noises. And it's dead. Why are you dead? Huh? Come back to life. Come on. Oh, it's the stupid other bend. Interesting. Yeah. I don't know. I'm going to just put this together. And put a knob on it. And yeah, we'll call this one done too. been a crazy night of very strange sounds here. Okay, let's see. Does it still work? That sounds pretty ridiculous. You know what? This nut came loose. Hold on. Fix this guy real quick. This guy came loose. This is all about having fun, you know? Do that all the way up. Now I gotta put a knob on the other guy. Let's pick one of those. I think I might need a smaller screwdriver for this. You know, I might have one. Nope, I don't. Crap. Let me go grab another smaller screwdriver there. Wonka, what's up, man? Soldering station died today. I'm not happy about it. It's only 4 months old. Ooh. Yeah, that sucks. What brand was it? Hold on one second. I gotta grab a small screwdriver. Okay. Yeah, what brand was that soldering iron? Because that's really not good at 4 months. Okay. I'm going to do that. Now let's get this thing. I'm going to unplug that, put the antenna back. I have no idea what that other little wire goes to, but I'm just going to leave it in there. Circuit specialist, still under warranty. Ugh. Still, man, that sucks. Man, what a mess I made. Okay. Let's get this put back together. And then I'll show you kind of what this all looks like. Ooh, jeez. Is this not lined up right? Pump it. Oh, it's a desoldering station. Oh, shit. Yeah, that sucks, man. What did I do here? Thing is pissed. Hey, knock it off. Yeah, sadly it doesn't suck, which is the problem. Was it a Hacko brand or something, or what? You said it got it from Circuit Specialist. I don't know, is that like a, I guess I'm not familiar with them. Are they like a retailer or something? Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna scan some channels, some radio channels with this, and then we're gonna circuit bend them. Oh, they're their own brand. Okay, cool. That makes sense. Okay, there it is. Boom. We removed one of the speakers out of here, and we're using the speaker grill, the metal speaker grill, as a place for some knobs. This one is the power starve, and then this one is rerouting the audio output into the volume control, which does some real weird wacky stuff. So here, I'm gonna, and we put the quarter inch jack in it as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and play some of this for you, and let's play with it a little bit and see what we can make it do. FDM printer's coming tomorrow? Oh, that's gonna be cool as hell. Yeah, printing is badass. Okay, let me do this. I'm gonna mute myself, and then I'll just play the audio coming out of this guy.
They get a part of it, and there's a mess.
Ask questions that a stranger couldn't possibly answer. Call a phone number for your family or friends that you know to be genuine. Check the story out with someone else in your family or circle of friends, even if you've been told to keep it a secret. And cash, gift cards, and money transfers. Once the scammer gets the money, it's gone. This important message is brought to you by community outreach specialist Sherry Ashenbrenner. And there you have it for the Fox River Flow, which is brought to you by Bravo and Open Culture Magazine. For the latest coronavirus news and information, as well as how it impacts you both nationally and locally, listen to America's First News, weekdays from 6 a.m. to 7.
Okay, this thing's not really doing too much cool stuff, but I'm sure if I scanned the stations and then did a power starve on it, it'd probably do something. I probably could find some cool stuff, but I don't know. Right now, not finding shit. It's a country station or something. There's a good distortion, so that's just, you know, Power Starve doing its thing. Oh yeah, those Prusier ones are great, man. I've got one of those at work and one of those actually for home as well. All right, well, you know, there we go. That's how you circuit bend a thing, right? We'll do circuit bending stuff more in the future. I think this one was kind of a fail though, because it's not really that great. It doesn't really do cool stuff. But, you know, at least it was good practice to try and poke around on something. You usually want something with some sort of synthesizer in it, or like any kind of like kid's toy with a voice synthesizer or a, you know, like a ton of other things, like drum machines and little things that you like hit a button and it like says like a number or something like that. I don't know. It's kind of cool. But this, yeah, I don't know. Yeah, it didn't really do too much. It was destined for the garbage anyway, so it's fine. All right, guys. Well, I think I'm going to end the stream there. But thank you for joining me tonight. Yeah, and Wonko, yes, 3D printers are badass. Those ones you got are also badass. And the five filament feeders, oh, they're on back order. Those things are a pain in the ass. So I have one of those at work, and I rarely use it because it's such a pain in the ass. So, all righty, guys. Well, cool. You guys all have a good night. Thank you for joining me, and I will see you guys soon.